Machine learning.
AI.
Machine learning.
Artificial intelligence.
Machine learning.
Machine learning or AI.
Machine learning.
Machine learning.
AI.
Confusing, right? Artificial intelligence and machine learning are often used interchangeably. So they must relate to each other. But how? AI, or artificial intelligence, is the science of training machines to perform human tasks. The term was invented in the 1950s, when scientists began exploring how computers could solve problems on their own. Most of the time, when you hear AI, you probably see these ridiculous images.
I grew up at the time where we were watching The Jetsons and 2001, A Space Odyssey, where they had HAL, the talking computer. So for me, artificial intelligence is really like a computer or machines that are given properties, human-like properties.
We take for granted how our brains effortlessly calculate the world around us every second of every day. AI is the concept that a computer can do the same.
All of our speech interfaces for our devices are AI. I mean, it's incredible. You can have an accent, you can be speaking a particular dialect that, as long as there's data on the internet with that language, these AI systems can quickly develop a way of interacting.
I can pick up my phone and I can ask it questions. Like I can say, Siri, say my name.
You're Tom, but since we're friends, I get to call you MR Smiley.
While AI is the broad science of mimicking human abilities, machine learning is a specific subset of AI that trains a machine how to learn. Machine learning models look for patterns in data and try to draw conclusions, like you or I would.
They're not being explicitly programmed by people. You can actually give them examples, and they're going to learn what to do from those examples. That's a huge difference because it's much easier for us humans to give examples than it is for us to write code.
Once the algorithm gets really good at drawing the right conclusions, it applies that knowledge to new sets of data.
That's the life cycle. It's ask the question, collect the data, train the algorithm, try it out, collect the feedback, use the feedback to make the algorithm better so that you have increasing accuracy and performance. Ta-da, machine learning.
You look at the Google car, it has lasers on the top, which are telling it where it is in terms of the surrounding area. It has radar in the front, which is informing the car of the speed and motion of all the cars around it. And it uses all of that data to figure out not only how to drive the car, but also to figure out and predict what potential drivers around the car are going to do. And that's almost a gigabyte a second of data that that car is processing.
One of the things that they're working on is, for example, the scanning of tumors. So taking x-rays and taking photographs of when they scan the outside of the body and they're looking for tumors. And can you just imagine one day where they could actually do a scan and determine whether a tumor is benign or not, instead of having to go in and take a sample every time they're trying to figure out what's going on inside your body? That's very Star Trek, right?
And if you look at the number of continuous streaming information from IoT, from the beacons and sensors, it gives us the ability to understand our environment much more intimately than we ever could before. And that's what AI and ML need. They need granular data, they need very large volumes of data, and they need extremely diverse data sources to be able to find the patterns and learn.
So if we can have a chatbot tell us in the morning, well, tell me the latest news. Okay, so it can read the stock market, it can read all the financial numbers that you need, and actually sort of not just tell you the numbers, but tell you the story behind the numbers in a human interpretable way. I think that's really valuable. When I think about what's new and coming, I don't know if so much mathematics is changing, but the types of things we do.
There you have it. AI is the science of computers emulating humans. And machine learning is a method behind how machines learn from data. There are so many problems to solve based on data. Why not let an algorithm take care of a few?